How to revise everything for maximum recall. When you're preparing for competitive examinations like RBI or SBI, banking like IBPS or even UPSC, the fight is twofold. One fight is to cover everything. The syllabus itself is huge and humongous, and therefore covering everything is a major fight that we students face. The second major fight is to revise everything in time so that you can recall it in the examination. And this is a bigger fight because 90% of the students, if not less, are able to cover the syllabus, but majority of us are not able to recall the right thing at the right time in the examination hall. Now, why does this happen? This happens because of one small reason: our habit of not revising whatever we are reading. So more important than covering 100% of the syllabus is to cover it in such a way that you're able to recall it in the examination. There are three major and very easy steps that you have to make a part of your habit and your reading activity so that you're able to recall the right thing at the right time. What is the first step? The first step is to revise daily. In my video on how to make notes, I have explained how to do active recalling or active revision. You need to do this active revision regularly every day. Now, before going to sleep, it's very important that you take out 1 hour, a minimum of 1 hour, and ask yourself, whatever I read today, whatever I covered today, how much of it do I remember now? And you do an active revision. This is what is called as active revision. You question yourself every point of your revision exercise, okay? And you do this for 1 hour straight before sleeping. Believe me, your sleep quality will be better because you would have revised everything and you'll be more content with your day. Your revision will make sure that whatever you have read has gone to a different part of the brain. So now, even after 1 month of this small exercise, you'll be able to recall majority of whatever you've read. So this is step one, daily revision and active revision. The second step is weekly revision. Every Sunday, you take out about 3-4 hours and you revise whatever you have read from Monday to Saturday. Now, this can be an active revision if you have more time, which means that you question yourself about whatever you're reading. For example, let's say you read about efficient market hypothesis. So you question yourself, okay, Anuj, tell me, what is efficient market hypothesis? And the keyword that you can see in your notes is that according to efficient market hypothesis, the technical analysis and fundamental analysis are useless to forecast the price of a stock. Do I remember what is weak, what is semi-strong, and what is strong efficient market hypothesis, or have I forgotten their differences? So this is called active revision. You can do this on a weekend, but if you have less time, let's say you're a working professional and you want to cover more during the weekends and you don't want to spend the day revising when you should be covering majority of your syllabus, so you do a passive revision on weekends, wherein you just open your notes and you just go through everything. So this is how you do passive revision. If you have less time, you can do passive revision on weekends. If you have more time, you can do active revision also on weekends. It is going to take more time, of course. But remember that in step one, which is daily revision, you have to do active revision only and not passive revision. And the third step is monthly revision. So what you do in monthly revision is, at the end of every month, 1st May to 1st June, or 1st May to 31st May, the month is over. From 1st June to 7th June, 7 days I'm going to keep only for revision. Before moving forward, I should be certain that whatever I have spent, whatever I have read in the last 1 month, I remember all of it or majority of it. This will also give you a reality check of how much you have covered in this past 1 month. And you will feel that you're staying away from this rat race of covering more and more and more and more syllabus, but not looking back to see whether you remember the syllabus also or not. Okay, looking back and asking yourself, questioning yourself whether you remember whatever you have read is equally important, if not more. So these are the three main ways of revising your syllabus regularly. And believe me, if you follow it for a year, nobody can stop you from getting selected. If you understand and if you question yourself truly on every concept that you read, every fact that you read, and if you revise regularly, nobody on this earth can stop you from getting selected in these exams. If you really like what I discuss and how I am helping you guys study better and study smarter, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and press that bell icon. All the best, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.